Kev, you better wait.
Yeah.
I'm assuming, like most people, myself and everybody else, you try diet plans, you know, you hire trainers. Did you find that these things worked for you? Or they, because they didn't work, you decided to go into the Fit Men Cook?
Yeah, you know, the things work up to a certain extent. Like, you get a personal trainer at the time, and they'll, you know, and they'll train you, and you could lose some weight, and they'll tell you to go ahead and eat this and that. And you lose the weight, but here's one thing that they actually don't tell you. A lot of people can eat for fuel and not for taste. And growing up in the South, my dad's from South Carolina. Mom's from Mississippi, so I grew up with good flavor in the house. I also grew up in
Texas. Y'all like that good eating.
Yeah, we love good eating. We love love in our food. We love all the flavors, right? So they don't teach you how to do that. And so what I learned is that, like, I would be going well, and all of a sudden be like, dang, this is so bad. And I would just relapse. And it was because of that, that's when I kind of realized that, all right, God, this doesn't make any sense. I don't think that you would put us on this earth, have all these amazing cuisines, all these amazing foods, and say you can't eat it. That just didn't sound right to me. So I've kind of realized when I sat down and started to, you know, dissect my own diet that, no, it's not about that. It's about the way that we prepare the food, and it's also about the portions. If I can teach myself those two things, then I can eat what I want and live better and happier with taste.
Okay, so let's start there. Kev, myself, I hate cooking. Did you always love cooking?
No, I didn't. But you know what? Here's the thing. I tell guys this, too. Well, everybody. But there's something that kind of wakens up inside of you whenever you get into the kitchen. Like, I was not that guy. But I tell you what, desperation and being on food stamps and not being able to afford a personal trainer and being tired of the way that you feel will motivate you to get off that couch and get to cooking, right? So that was a motivation for me to get up and start cooking some stuff. But I think that once you get into the kitchen and you start to make something, you feel good. You get like the serotonin boost because first off, you are starting something from scratch and you're making it all the way through. And then all of a sudden you get this wonderful finished cooked meal, right? Mm-hmm. So a bit about that. You have the compounded effect, though, when you're eating healthier food that, oh, this food is actually good for me. So even as I'm eating it, I'm feeling nourished and I'm feeling energized by it. So cooking healthy food is just a win overall. Yes, as in anything, I don't care if this is your first day in the gym, if this is your first day trying to prepare for that marathon, you're going to feel kind of clumsy and it's not going to feel great. But you just give yourself a moment and all of a sudden you're like, oh, this is easy. I can really do this.
What's up, guys? Thanks for sticking with me to the end of the video. Truly appreciate you. If you like anything you heard here today, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. And if you know anybody that can benefit from this message, feel free to share. Peace and love.